Hi everyone, Chris Tisdell here again. In this presentation, I'm going to show you how to measure the size of a complex number. In fact, we're going to answer the question, how big are complex numbers? Now, in previous videos, I talked about basic operations with complex numbers, the complex conjugate, and some examples involving those ideas. So this presentation is the next step. We're going to measure how big complex numbers are. So let me share my screen with you and we can get started. Okay, so if I write down, say, two complex numbers, z, say, is 2 minus I, and w is 1 plus I, which one of those complex numbers is bigger? Well, it's not totally clear. Because, I mean, the real part of z is larger than the real part of w, but there's a negative sign with the I here and a positive sign with the I there. So which one is bigger? It's not clear. So that's one of the ideas that we're going to tackle today. Okay, and the idea that we're going to measure size with is known as the modulus. Okay, now essentially it just uses right angles, triangles, and Pythagoras' theorem. Okay, so let me just run you through and I'll do a simple example. Suppose I have a complex number z in this x plus yi form, the Cartesian form, x and y are real numbers. Then we define the modulus or the magnitude of z by z with these parallel vertical lines there. It's just the sum of the squares of x and y, the real and imaginary parts, and just square root it. Now, geometrically, the modulus represents the length r of the line segment connecting z to the origin in the complex plane or in an Argand diagram. So let me just sort of show you what I mean. This is the horizontal axis is the real axis, and the vertical axis is the imaginary axis. So let's say I had, z equals 3 plus 4i. What is the modulus of this complex number? Well, let's draw it in the Argand diagram or in the complex plane. So I'd go 3 units out here to the right, and I'd go 4 units up. So I'd be about there, okay? Now, if I take that point and I draw a little line segment connecting that point to the origin, then I want to measure this distance here. Okay? Now, what we've got essentially is a right-angled triangle. Okay, so I'm just going to use Pythagoras here. Okay, the length of the base is 3, the length of this vertical side is 4, and I'm interested in this length here. So if we apply Pythagoras' theorem, we have the following, okay? The square of the hypotenuse is the sum of the squares of the other three sides. And this is going to be 25, so r is going to be 5 in this case. Okay, so that's the modulus of this complex number. Okay, so it's nothing more than Pythagoras' theorem. Okay, so that was pretty easy. Now, the modulus has a number of properties. I just wanted to step you through some of them. Okay, and I'll prove some of these in other presentations. But, you know, as an exercise, you might like to see if you can prove some of these basic basic properties. Okay, so suppose I have, say, two complex numbers, z and w. The modulus or the length is always non-negative. And the modulus is zero if and only if the complex number z is zero, the thing inside the modulus sign. If you square a complex number and take the modulus, then it's the same as taking the modulus first and then squaring. There is what's known as a triangle property, or inequality. Okay, that says that if you take two complex numbers and add them together and take the modulus, that's always less than or equal to the sum of the two moduli. And if you have a real number, alpha, and you multiply through and then take the modulus, it's the same as taking the modulus first and then multiplying. Here, the modulus, the parallel lines mean absolute value of the real number alpha. So sometimes it's a little bit tricky on, here the two parallel lines mean absolute value of alpha. So it's pretty clear whether we're talking about absolute value or modulus just by the context. Okay, the modulus of a product of two complex numbers is the same as the product of the moduli. Okay, and I can connect the conjugate of z bar with the modulus in the following way. If you have a complex number and you multiply by a conjugate, it's the same as the square of the modulus. So this product here is the square of the length from z to the origin. Okay. Now, if I wanted to prove this, what you would do is we can probably do it a number of ways. You can say I just stopped there for a minute. Okay. So here, if you want to prove this thing down here, then we could look at the left-hand side and show that it equals the right-hand side. So a plus bi times the modulus, which is a minus bi. Okay, so if you say expand that out, I'm going to get a squared minus abi plus abi, so they'll cancel. And then when I multiply the bi with negative bi, the I squared equals negative 1, remember? So I'll get plus b squared there. Now, that is the square of the modulus. Okay, so that's one way of proving it. Okay, let's do a basic example. I'll do some of the proofs for these in other videos. They probably need their own particular video to actually prove it, but I've got a real basic example lined up here. Here we've got two complex numbers z and w, 7 plus I and 3 minus I respectively. We are asked to calculate the modulus of z plus I w. So it's just a pretty simple calculation. All right, so let's work out z plus I w and look at the modulus of that. All right, so z plus I w is this plus I times this. Okay, and I can simplify this. So when I distribute this I, I'm going to get 3i, and I'm going to get negative I squared. Remember, I squared equals negative 1, so negative I squared will be positive 1, right? So I'm going to get 7 plus 1, which will be 8, and I'm going to get I plus 3i, which is 4i. So I want to look at the modulus of the complex number 8 plus 4, right? So I take the real part and the imaginary part, 8 and 4, square them, add them together, and take the square roots. Okay, so I'm going to get 64 plus 16, which is going to be 80. Okay, and 80 is just 16 times 5, so I can reduce that down to 4 root 5. Okay, all right, so nothing too deep about that example, just a simple calculation. Okay, so that's a little bit of insight into this, the way of measuring how big complex numbers are. Okay, and in forthcoming videos, I'll talk more about more involved examples and deeper examples, and I'll do some proofs from the table that I showed you. So if you have any suggestions, any comments, you can always put them in the comments section. I hope you can join me for the next presentation where I'll continue my series on complex numbers. See you later.